All right, here we go. Water bottle science. Give me a sec, let me clean this up. Thanks. Water bottles. I know everybody has them, and now I'm gonna show you how to do science. What's that? Hold on. Science Hen needs to take care of some business first. Yes, we'll wait. Y'all better? Okay, good. Water, but this isn't from the bathroom, is it? Okay. Water bottles. I know everybody has them, so if you have one, go grab them and let me show you what we can do with them. The first one, we need some safety equipment. I brought my safety equipment. Here's what it is. Today, we're going to use a little bit of fire. So, we're going to use safety glasses and leather gloves. Now, there's one thing about playing with fire that you need to know, is that if you ever do that, make sure you're customarily outside or in a nice fireproof science lab, and make sure you're wearing cotton clothing. You never want to wear synthetics, because if they catch fire or hit a spark, it tends to melt and it burns you and it hurts. So that's why I'm wearing complete cotton and leather gloves. Science Hand, you got your sight? Oh, good, gloves. And glasses, good. And can you show everybody else what else we brought to be safe?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. This is also very important, especially if you're doing it inside. Ah, fire extinguishers. So are we ready?
Uh-huh.
Sweet. I got a couple more things I gotta grab from the science table, which is this. This is a little science jar of alcohol. This is rubbing alcohol. This is the same stuff that you use on your skin to disinfect. It's also, if you get an owie or a scrape, you put this on to clean it, to disinfect it. However, it's also flammable. Did you guys know that? Yeah, it is. We're gonna use it with water bottles to create something really cool. Science Hand, I have all my stuff except for water bottles. You have a small water bottle down there?
Uh-huh.
Let me see it. Ah, perfect. So we have a small water bottle. Now you can tell that's a little bit used. Guess what I've done before with this particular bottle? Yeah, I've used it. So, we're gonna take the isopropyl alcohol, we're gonna squirt some in there, just a little bit. Now be careful, don't get it on the lip of the container. The reason is, well, the reason will be very evident in a moment. So I put the alcohol in there, and we're gonna mix it up, because alcohol by itself is not flammable. It needs to be mixed with, does anybody know? What do you have to mix alcohol with to make it burn? Anyone? Yes, you guys in Tennessee, just venture a guess, go. Fire, yes, to make fire, we need to add alcohol. Thank you, everybody. Oh, I love you too, Tennessee, I love you. That's good, thumbs up to you too, love you. This was small, let's do a bigger one. Do you have a bigger water bottle down there you can find? Yeah. No, not the biggest one. Let's just do a medium-sized one. Yeah, like that one. Yeah, that one, perfect. So. Nice little bottle. Does it matter what type of plastic bottles you have? Nah, not really. You can use basically anyone's. These are just ones that I happen to have around the house. And most of you realize that most of the stuff we do here at Spark Science is stuff around the house, which makes it really easy to do. So I took the residue of the alcohol, we're gonna put it in there, and we're gonna add just a little bit more, because we have a bigger bottle. Duh, easy. So. Mix that up. Time for a test question. We're mixing the air with what? What is it again? Air with It's the alcohol, yes, it's the alcohol, but what part of the alcohol is it? What did we call it?
Vapor.
The vapor, exactly right. So we have alcoholic vapor and air or oxygen, and we get this. Here we go. I think it needs a little bit more mixing. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna put a little bit more. Now, sometimes what you need to do is add a little bit of air to it. So put your hand on it, make sure that it's not on fire. Then, from a distance, blow. Introduce more oxygen to it. If we got the right amount of mix, which we did, that happens. So, we had small, we had medium. What's it time for?
Big.
Large. Science hand. We need a large bottle. You got one down there? Show me. Oh, yeah. Small, medium, and large. All right. So, we're going to put the residue in here. Remember how I told you you don't want to get the alcohol on the lip? The reason is when that jet of flame shoots up out of the bottle, it tends to burn the lip if you spill alcohol on it. So just kind of be careful. If you do happen to spill some alcohol on the lip, wipe it off. And you can wipe it off with your bare hand because remember, your bare hands and alcohol equals dead bacteria. And now is a really good time to kill bacteria on your hands. So. We've got some alcohol in there. I think we need a little more. Should we put a little bit more in, guys?
Heck yeah.
Oh, yeah. Heck yeah, exactly right. We're gonna do that. That's my crew, that's my local crew helping me out here, which is really cool. So, got more, add in some air. Now, make sure that when you do this at home, your parents are with you. Why? Because it's really cool, they're gonna wanna see it. And because we need them to make sure that you're being safe. Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Yeah! Alcohol, water bottles. It's science.
Wait, what?
Spark science.
All right. Final score. Or game match, game point. Ah, well, you won that one. Oh, we're back, we're back, we're back, we're on. Water bottles. We've done a lot of fun things with them, but now we're gonna do something a little bit different, still using water bottles. So for this, we don't need our safety gear. This one is very safe. There are four ways to make things disappear. This next one is one of them. So, for this, of course, we're going to need a water bottle. In particular, a 2-liter bottle. This is something that probably everybody has. Now you can see that I have a whole bunch of water in there. What we're gonna do is introduce something into the water bottle and make it disappear. The science of this is called the science of refraction. I want everybody to say refraction with me. Ready? As loud as you can. 1, 2, 3.
Refraction!
Yeah! That's a really, really fancy word for bending. The light is going to come through the water bottle and it's going to bend around the object that we put in there and essentially make it disappear. Simple enough to understand, if light doesn't hit anything, you can't see it. That's what nighttime is. Yes, we know. So now we have a water bottle, we have water. Now we just need some stuff to put in the water bottle. Science hand. We need some stuff for this experiment. Do you have anything that we can put in the water bottle to make it disappear? Cool, let me see. That's a pepperoni. No, that's not gonna work. No, that's a D20. That's for Enter the Hex. I need something for the water bottle. No, okay. This is my fault. I need something long and hard. Yes, like a screw. Thank you, science hand. A screw. This could also be a nail. Now, we're gonna introduce the screw to it. Now this is gonna be fun. If you can't see this, don't worry. Trust me, it works. In fact, all the more reason for you to go home and try it. Now, camera guys, this is gonna be a tricky shot. I don't know if you can see this or zoom in on this, but the screw is of course at the bottom. Can you see that? Give me a thumbs up if you guys can see that. Can you guys see that at home? Can you guys see that out in the audience? But the screw is right there on the bottom. Now, keep it focused on that bottle as I bring it down. And as soon as I get to about the level of my chin, and hopefully for the camera, you'll notice that the screw completely vanishes. It's gone. You guys see that? If you can't see it from where you're at, don't worry. Try this at home. It's gone. That's because the light is bending around the screw. Now, that was a cute little screw. Should we do something bigger? Oh, absolutely. Science hand, we need a bigger screw. Do you have a bigger screw, please? Yeah, go. That's not a screw. Yeah, I don't think your brother's gonna be happy with that. A bigger screw. No, we don't want to put your brother in there. Okay, one more time. A big screw. A big screw! He got it. Thank you, science hand. Now, how many of you, raise your hand and you can do this at home. I can't see you, but that's okay. How many of you think we can make this disappear? It's a lot bigger. Raise your hand. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 439,832 of you think that we can make this disappear. Okay? All of words think that we can't make this disappear. Raise your hands. 4. Okay, well, let's see who's right and who's wrong. There it is. Tilt it horizontally. Bring it up. It's still there. Science hand. Can you see that? Okay, good. Here we go. Come down. Bring it down. Bring it down. Bring it down. Ah. Gone. We made a big screw disappear. Now, you remember how I tell you that you need to go home and try this yourself and just grab stuff? Science hand, guess what? I brought a whole bunch of stuff. I know, I always feel bad because I make you do so much work. No, just hang on right there. Will you just watch the water bottle for a second, make sure no one runs off with it? Check this out, guys. I brought a whole bunch of other stuff to try and see if we can make it disappear as well. So I've got a metal straw. Look at that. That's cool. That's one of my favorite straws. It's a metal straw. You want to hold that, science hand? Okay, we're going to put that in last. I brought a blue pencil. I brought a red pencil. I brought a Bic pen, a little tiny screw, and a ball bearing. So we're going to start with, well, we're not going to start with a ball bearing because it just went there. Science hand, can you run and go grab the ball bearing for me, please? Thank you. So we're going to start with a little tiny screw. Now, I know this is boring because we've already seen two screws, but what the heck, we're going to do a little tiny screw as well. And 1, 2, 3. Yeah, we already knew that, didn't we? It's gone. Can't see it at all. Oh, you brought the ball back. Thank you. Nice. I want to do this. Pencils. What are pencils going to do when you add them to water? Anyone? That's right. Exactly right. Thank you, Hawaii. We have friends from Hawaii watching this. They're going to float. Of course, the people in Hawaii would know that because they live on an island. And they wouldn't survive if they didn't float. I know islands don't float, but you know, you've got a lot of detritus. So, the question is can we make this work with a floating pencil? Now, we've got water that's not all the way at the top, so what are we gonna do? We're gonna add some more water. So that's good that I brought some more water and a funnel. Because I did this just before I came here, because I wanted to see this, if this would actually work. Should I tell you whether it worked or not? No, I'm not going to, that would ruin the punchline. But I am gonna add some more water to it. So, this time, we're gonna try and get the pencil in exactly the same position, except instead of resting at the bottom of the container, it's going to rest at the top. You think it's gonna vanish or not? How many of you? Raise your hand if you think it's gonna vanish. Well, wow, we have a unanimous vote. All 42 million of you think it's going to, oh, and science hand. All right, well, get over there. There we go. Okay, ready? Pencil's there. Science hand, can you see the pencil? Good. And we bring it down, bring it down. Now, remember, the order for this to work, you need to about level with your chin, and I'm gonna try and level it with the camera, right there. Did it vanish? Yes, it did. That's just cool. It's science.
Spark science.
Water bottles. We're not done yet. I've got another one for you that's really fun. And it's right, let's see, where is Science Hand? Oh, there he is. Science Hand, we did this one, and we did that one. Oh! Excuse me, Science Hand, it's time to go to the science corner. Science Corner, for those of you that don't know, is when we have a special guest that comes and joins us every week. So we're going to go over there and find out who our special guest is now. Let's see. I'm going to put that down. And Science Corner. Ooh, it's mobile. Did you know that Science Corner was mobile? I didn't. No, it did. I've been doing this for like weeks and I didn't even know that. Oh, cool. Nice. Science Corner, hi. There he is. Hi. Oh, hey, look, it's Science Hand's brother. How are you? Oh, he's what? There he is. Hi. Hey, who's our special guest this week? Oh, thank you very much. Our special guest this week is Mr. 10K. Now, he's a pyrotechnician, he's an adult, and he builds fireworks. Let's see what he's doing this week. Hey, Mr. 10K,
hey guys,
what's
welcome
up?
Welcome back to the Pyro Shed. Now, today I am making inserts for a mine. Now, I previously added a little bit of powder on one end.
Whoa, that's cool.
So that powder burns blue, as you can see. The next step is putting them into this ring. Got the powdered end at the very bottom, and the other end is opened. I'm gonna put them in here so I can add some more powder. The next step is placing a sleeve on the top and then adding the other powder until it looks like
there's like 50.
This. Now at this point, the insert is almost done. I would have to add a little bit of glue on the top to close off that other end and then put a little bit of black powder on the other end. Let them dry for 24 hours and that will complete this type of insert. Now since this project isn't complete, I will show you a clip of a past project I did with jumping jacks as the insert.
Oh, nice. Wow. I want to be his neighbor, right? That's pretty cool. Hey, thanks, Mike. We'll check in with you again later. Water bottles. I almost skipped one, and it would be a shame if I missed it. We're not done using fire on water bottles, so we need to go get our safety equipment back, as well as this water bottle, sprinklers, alcohol, and safety gear. Actually, we'll use this glasses for it. Now, this works really well this time of year. I've tried to do this experiment outside during the winter and it just doesn't work because the alcohol that we use for this experiment, the vapor pressure isn't compatible with the cold temperatures outside. So right now is a perfect time to go outside and try this experiment. Now, as you notice, we're in a theater, we're here in the science lab, and I've modified this just a little bit to make it safe for inside. Let me show you the modification I made. These are my rocket launchers. This is my rocket fuel, which makes this, the rocket. I know, it's just a water bottle. Yeah, it's just a water bottle, it's fine. Anyway, the rocket launchers are what I modified. If you'll notice, there's big red buttons on those. You know how you're told never push big red? You know how you're told never push big red buttons? With this experiment, push the big red buttons. When you push this, something happens. Listen. Click, click, click. Now, what you probably can't see because the studio lights are too bright is there is a little spark that is going right across the top of that. Okay? This may look familiar to some of you. It's a barbecue igniter, literally. It's got two wires connected to the base here that run up through the sprinkler pipe and end. But this is where this experiment gets a little weird. Because remember how I told you a little while ago with the alcohol volcano that it's the vapor that we use? It's exactly the same thing here. It's the alcohol vapor, which means that we don't want to use the fluid. In fact, it is very important that you empty out all the fluid that you just put in, because we only want the vapor. What happens if you don't get all of the fluid out of the rocket? Yeah, you've done it before, I know. Or you've done it too? Yeah, you've done that? Yeah. It tends to light your rocket launcher on fire, and then you're holding a flaming stick. And if you're not expecting that, it's not good. So we're gonna be very careful with this. put my safety glasses back on. And these are ANSI related. They're safety related glasses, rated glasses. Man, words, science hand, I'm having a hard time. All right, you want to go first or you want me to go first? Oh, you want me to go first? No, let's have you go first. All right, here we go. So we're gonna put that on there after we've emptied out almost all of the fluid. Now, for this one, it's a rocket launch, so we need a countdown. Ready? Everybody, as loud as you can. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1! Yay, whoa! So our theater ceiling is about 15 feet from floor to ceiling. So that traveled about 7 feet, which for our things is perfect. No, it's not. I want a big explosion. How many of you guys want a big rocket explosion? Yeah, we're gonna do this for real. Okay, science hand, go get in the science bunker, will ya? Here we go. So we add the same amount of alcohol. You don't have to add a lot. It's just a little tiny bit. And of course, the important part is to get it all out. I've had some people ask me over time, hey, how come you don't fill the whole thing with alcohol? And the reason is that it wouldn't work. Remember, the only way that rockets, and specifically this type of rockets, work in a water bottle is if it mixes with air. So if you fill the whole thing up with alcohol, there's no room for the air, duh. All right. Now for this one, I'm gonna go stand back here. You'll see why in a second. All right. For this one, I'm also gonna hold this away from my face. You ready? Front row people, get ready. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well, that was anticlimactic. Try that again. What the? So, yeah. There we go. It's science.
Science.
Oh, water bottles. I've got one more thing to show you, but I need science hand again. Science hand, hi. Could you pick out, like 5 volunteers from the audience for me today, please? This one's really cool. Just a little tiny bit of fire, but you'll see why. And we don't need safety precautions because this is very easy to do. If you do this at home, make sure your parents are with you. Oh yeah, come on down, guys. And stand in line right here. Hi, you are?
William.
William.
Anderson.
Alyssa.
Riley.
Riley.
Bridget.
Oh, Bridget, okay, great. Let's see if we have enough. One for you, William. One for you, Anderson. One for you, Alyssa. One for you, Riley. One for you, Bridget. Now, and I will take mine. The first thing we need to do is empty our water bottles. Yeah, and notice I handed you all big ones. So come right over here into the science volcano. I want you to empty your water bottles. So open the lids, come over here, and dump out almost all of the water. Ready, go. There's a reason why we're doing this. Because water bottles are used today to make clouds. Yeah, we're literally gonna make clouds inside a building using water bottles. So what we want to have is just a tiny little bit of water at the bottom of it. Riley, you see how there's just like just a tiny little bit?
Yeah.
Okay, did you, yours looks empty. Is yours empty? I'm gonna add a little bit of water to mine. Now this is, wow, I can't believe I worked that without making a science mess. Riley, I'm gonna add a little bit more to yours. And Alyssa, a little bit more to yours. Good, and you're good, you're good, all right. For this, take a match, light it, and drop it into your water bottle. As soon as I do, I want you to put the lid on tight on your water bottle. So there's the fire, that's it, that's all we need. Just a tiny little bit. The fire does something interesting in cloud formation. It creates soot, or smoke particles. Scientists call the soot cloud condensation nuclei. That's a really big word. Everybody say it with me, ready? Cloud condensation nuclei. It's just a fancy name for dust. because clouds cannot form without a little bit of dust. Now, if you look very carefully, you'll see mine's got a fair amount of smoke in it. How's, do you guys have any smoke in yours that you can see? Just a little bit? Okay. Mostly there's nothing. Here's the key part of this experiment that's very, very critical. Make sure your lid is on airtight, okay? Good, you ready? What you're gonna do is we're all gonna squeeze these bottles as hard as we can for about 10 seconds. Pause. Science hand. Would you do me the honor of doing this one? Okay, you're gonna squeeze that as hard as you can for 10 seconds. When I say go, go. Go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, release! In that moment, a cloud formed inside of the bottle. We need to show everybody. So open your lids, unscrew your lids, and squeeze them out to let everybody see your clouds. Whoa. Guys, this isn't smoke. These are actual condensate clouds. Yeah. Guys, that's awesome. It's science. Good job. Okay, everybody take a seat.
You know, that reminds me of the very first time I found my granddad hiding in the freezer. You ain't scaring me again!
Spark Science!
You know, science is really like a puzzle. When you first look at it, it looks kind of difficult. Maybe a little scary. Might even look impossible. But as with everything, you work at it, you try different things, different moves, and eventually, you come up with a solution. Looks like I'm gonna have to work on this one a little bit longer. But now it's your turn. You've seen water bottle science, now it's your turn. Ready? Go! See you next week! We're doing science dancing. That's great.